Good morning. Maybe it's not morning. Maybe you're just looking for some tips on how to get up early in the morning. Well, it's not always easy. I haven't always been a morning person, but I decided a long time ago that if I wanted to get my workouts in and I wanted to consistently be able to do that, I had to get up early. With family and work, I'm not one to work out at night, so early was my only option. Here are five tips I've used in the past to help myself get out of bed. I still use them today when I travel and I'm jet lagged. So these will help you. You just have to start to use some self-discipline along with these tips, and over time, it gets easier and easier. Number one is starting slowly. Kind of like diet, I've mentioned it in the past. Don't just start a workout plan, getting up early, and a diet all on the same day. Slowly start to make changes, and that's the best way that they're going to last and be the least painful, honestly. So if you want to start getting up earlier, maybe it's an hour earlier or an hour and a half, and you really, really struggle, well, start by just moving your clock 10 to 15 minutes back each day. And do that for a few days until you slowly can start to wake up earlier. Most of the time now, I wake up before the alarm goes off, 5 minutes, 10 minutes before it goes off. And at that point, I just get out of bed. I don't even stay in bed. If I wake up within 15 minutes of the alarm going off, I get out of bed at that point because I don't want to have to go through the alarm waking me up and being groggy. So if you wake up before the alarm goes off, 10 minutes or so, get out of bed. Don't make yourself go through that groggy state when the alarm goes off. Number two might seem obvious, but we don't always stick to it. Go to bed earlier. Everyone who knows me knows I go to bed by 9 o'clock. I like being in bed 8:30, 8:45. Maybe I'm winding down. I might be watching a few things on my phone. One thing I try not to do is watch too many things on my phone right before I'm going to sleep. Because if I'm going to bed early, maybe I'm not tired that day for some reason. If I'm sitting there watching TV or playing on my phone, I'll tend to stay awake longer than I should. But if I just go in early, turn the lights out, get into bed, and if I'm struggling a little bit, maybe I'll read, because reading puts me to sleep really, really fast. You have to go to bed early. You can't shortchange yourself, especially over the long haul. If you start one day on 4 hours sleep, you're not gonna be able to continue to do that and get up early and be successful, stay healthy. You're going to have to go to bed earlier and earlier. I typically get anywhere between 6 and 7 hours of sleep. I try and go to bed by 9, 9:30, and I get up around 4. I have to get that amount of sleep, otherwise eventually it does catch up. Number three is moving the alarm away from the bed. I don't do this as much anymore because now I have a wife and I'm pretty disciplined. If my alarm goes off, I turn it off and I get out of bed immediately. But some people, they tend to hit that snooze button, or they hit that button and they lay there for a second and boom, they're back out. So take that alarm and put it on the other side of the room so you have to get up. That is definitely something I do in a hotel still to this day. If I'm traveling, and especially international, and my time is off and I'm tired and I know I'm not gonna wanna get out of bed in the morning, I'll take my iPad and I'll put it on the other side of the room with an alarm. I'll still put my phone next to my bed with an alarm, so when that one goes off, I can turn that off. I've already started to wake up, and if I don't get up within 5 minutes, that alarm across the room is going to go off. The other thing you can do is set multiple alarms on your phone. I will set one for 4 and then 4:05. Just in case I'm feeling tired and I don't get up, then that first one will go off and I don't hit the snooze button, but I have that second one just in case. Tip number four, which requires some self-discipline. When that alarm goes off, sit up and get out of bed. Don't lay there and think about how tired you are, or sit there and negotiate with yourself about getting up and wanting to go back to sleep. When the alarm goes off, sit up and get out of bed, go into the bathroom, turn on the lights, put some water on your face. Just don't sit in bed, because that's one of the biggest things that I think people do, is that alarm goes off, they turn the alarm off, and they lay there and they fall back to sleep. Number five is keeping a glass of water next to the bed. So as soon as that alarm goes off, you sit up and take as big of a drink of that water as you can, and that will really start to wake you up. I feel it's a really great way, because you get that cold water in you, all of a sudden you start to wake up. By the time you get in the bathroom, go to the bathroom, you'll start to feel better. So I use one of those Yeti cooler glasses and I put water in it with some ice and I put it next to the bed. That way I have it at night if I want it, but I always take a huge drink of it as soon as I wake up. Well, it is 4:42. I have to meet Mike in 5 minutes on the trail to run. I have to go, but I hope you enjoyed these tips. If you have any other tips for waking up early, things that you've done, put them in the comments. I love hearing your feedback. Thank you for the likes, the subscriptions, the comments, always appreciated. I hope these tips help you, and it takes time. It's not something that you just start waking up early and feeling great. And I don't always feel great when I wake up. There's days I would love to sleep in, and there are days that I wake up and I feel groggy and I feel miserable. But pushing through and getting through the workout, I never regret that. I never regret getting up early. I love seeing the sunrise every day. So I hope these work for you. I'll see you later.